you do at the board meeting is, first of all, the four wants. What is it that you want when you go to any meeting with anybody? You want something. People want something all day, every day, all over the planet. So it's just the four wants, according to the code. You go there saying what you want, what you are there for. You've got to know what you're there for. It's something that you want, evidently. Otherwise, why go? So you say, you tell them what it is you want. Next thing, why you want what you want. Next thing, what is the plan to get it? Well, part of the plan is letting them know what you want. Even if they're going to figure out what the plan is to give you what you want. And the fourth question, what do you expect the constructive result to be? Because the result should be something of constructive value. You don't want any non-constructive result. Why bother? You get non-constructive results everywhere, all day long. All right? So you must be very, very focused about what it is you're going to the meeting for. Lots of people go to meetings, they don't know why they're at the meeting. There's just everybody going around in a circle. Everybody talking and nobody making any sense about anything. And usually comes from not being focused. I mean super focused about what it is that you want and why you want it. And if you get it, what the constructive result is going to be. That's it. But you have to be well prepared when you go. And since you are asking for something that you want, try to stay in the question lane as much as you possibly can and don't make accusations. Once you start making accusations, you're going to get opposition, and that's usually not going to go nowhere. Just turn into a shouting match with everybody screaming, yelling, getting mad, and nothing getting done about what? About what you came there to get. You're going there to get something. You want to make sure that you stay focused on what you are there to get. Stay in the question lane. After you state what went on, say, now this happened. Number one, this happened. Number two, try to list everything by numbers. Number one, this is what happened today or last week or whatever. Number two, this is what happened, so-and-so. Because you're talking about things that were done.
Yes.
This is what was done. Number four, this is what was done. Number five, this is what was done. And then when you list everything, go down with a list of things that were done. Then ask a question after you go through your list of things that were done that you think should not have been done, but you don't say that they shouldn't have been done. You just list what was done.
Mm-hmm.
Then, when you finish saying what was done, then you say, should these things have been done? All right? That's your question. And let them answer, and you have all of your answers in writing. And don't, and let each person that talks, one person talks at a time, and don't ever move to a second question before you have thoroughly answered the first question, whatever the questions are. Don't move to the second question until the first question has been answered. Otherwise, you're going to get what? More confusion. One thing you don't want in any meeting ever for the rest of your existence on this planet and the other planet is confusion. Otherwise, there's no point in having the meeting.
Okay.
If it's just going to turn out to be a shouting match, that's a no-no. And if you stick to this formula, it shouldn't be.
Okay.
You just simply say what was done, and then go through each one of the things that was done and ask the question, should these things have been done? And if so, why?
Oh.
And you want your answers in writing.
Okay.
And you go from there. See, that's what codification is about. You do the same thing over and over again. Why? Because it's supposed to work. That's why. Otherwise, it's not code. So the procedure is exactly what I said a while ago. Anytime you're talking, talking to anybody. You want something. So what it is, you focus, first of all, you have to get your own mind straight about what it is you want. All right? Then you get your mind straight about what it is you don't want and why. But you put it in the form of a question when you apply, when you raise the issue to people who have the power to get it done. See, we're always talking about doing, not how anybody feels or anything like that. Throw feelings out of it altogether, period. And talk about whether something is correct or something is incorrect, because there's no such thing as in between. So you just simply ask questions. First of all, by saying what is going on, just like I said a while ago, you list it. Number one, this is happening. Number two, this is happening. Number three, this is happening. I'm talking about putting it on paper. Don't go in there ad-libbing or trying to think off the top of your head. That's a mistake. Have anything written down and read it just like you wrote it. This is happening. This is happening. And by the numbers. And when you run out of numbers, in other words, you cover everything that is going on that you think shouldn't be going on, and then you ask the people that you are talking to, number one, sir, ma'am, should this be the case? This number one. Should this be happening here? Number two, and get all of your answers in writing. And your answers will take, the answers that you get, if you're given any, is going to take anybody right where they need to be. That's codification. That's the codified manner of doing everything. Questions and answers.